Logos, pow.
Right, today we're going to be having a look at OpenBOR, or also known as Open Beats of Rage. This started life about 20 years ago, blimey, as a game called Beats of Rage, which used sprite bits from SNK fighting games to create a style-based crime beat-em-up, and it ended up being open source a year or two later, and then everybody could start making their own sideways scrolling beat-ups. And following some recent news that was published about a Open Beats of Rage game which got a cease and desist by Sega, and we'll come to that, I thought it might be a good idea to have a look at a few of the games which has sort of piqued my interest, shall we say. Let's take a look. Right, so this is my reason for doing this video. This is Golden Axe Returns. Very recently, there's a cease and desist by Sega, maybe because they're doing a new Golden Axe game soon, I suppose. But it's a fan game. It really pisses me off when they do stuff like that. But I'd already downloaded this. So let's have a look. Now bear in mind, this is made using Open Beats of Rage, so don't expect arcade greatness, but let's have a look. So select your character. You have Gilius, Axe, Tyrus, Drix. So you've got characters from other Golden Axe games, from like Golden Axe Revenge of Death Adder and Golden Axe 3, but we're going to go traditionalist with Tyrus. So a few bits and pieces there. Looks like it's four players. Let's go to Turtle Village because, you know, nostalgia. Oh look, there's a tombstone for Alex. He died here many years ago. And this guy's having a nap. Unfortunately, I've just stabbed his friend up. It's a bit gory, isn't it? I don't think you can throw characters. I did set fire to that guy. So far, so Golden Axe. Of course, it's got the music. I imagine Sega probably not happy about that. Oh, look, the ridey thing. Now, one thing I'll say, when I played this the other day, just to make sure it still worked, or did work properly, I lost my sword somehow, and I got on that and couldn't get off it, and couldn't get my sword back, because my sword was just sticking in the mud. So I'm not even going to try getting on it this time. Oh, look, Goblin's getting pissed up. Well done, Goblins. Right, let's get one of these. You see two types of Goblins here. You've got fat ones giving away food, and the slimy, mischievous ones giving away magic. Ah, it's the Chocolate Brothers. Now, how do I use my magic? There we go, like that. Wow, that didn't do a great deal. This is where I left my... Well, it's not where I lost my sword last time, but losing my sword was the same thing. But I managed to get it back, but I couldn't get off the animal to ride, that you do ride, to get it last time. So, oh, we've lost a life. Have the sword back. Come on. Oh, one of them's gone from me to you. Excellent. Right, here we go. Yeah, I am hungry. I've got full health, but I'm hungry. Alright, the Amazons are in attendance at Turtle Village. As they do now, can I chuck you off the edge of the cliff? Yes, I can. I love that beat so much, and you can do that. That's a steaming hot pot casserole there. Boy, this job does have some perks, doesn't it? Write that down in your copybook. And that guy just fell to his doom. Oh, crack Suicide Squad. And that guy's gonna fall down too. Excellent. Oh, really bad glowing knight guy. Can I use my magic? Yep, there we go. Magic it up. Wow, he was easy to kill. Well, a quick look at the next stage and we should probably move along. So I've got another 3 games to do. And Tyrus just fell asleep in the middle of the town square because reasons. Oh wow, new things. I think they're from Golden Axe Revenge of Death Adder, I think. These harpies. It's good that you've still got the option to fight with your fists if you have dropped your sword, rather than be completely defenceless. I'm sure there was a game that happened in, and I can't remember what it was. Right, we've reached into the, well, at least the front of the eagle, and there's a nice flag there, and we've got some knights. Yeah, but it's interesting this. I'm sure if you take some of the other routes, you probably will play Golden Axe 2 stages or Golden Axe 3 stages or other classic locations from Golden Axe. It's all very interesting, and it's all a really big shame that it's been completely shat upon by Sega's legal department. Because I think if people would enjoy it, it's not going to replace whatever they're doing with Golden Axe next. It really isn't. It's a real shame, though. Anyway, we've got some more games to look at after I've twisted myself down a hole. Fantastic. Yeah, Golden Axe. I would say try it, but you can't. And I will not be distributing this pack file to people, just note. Let's move on. Right, so next up we've got Air Gallet. Now, Air Gallet is a vertically scrolling aircraft-based shoot-em-up. And this is a Beats of Rage version of it. So it's a new war, and there's ripped bits from Sonic Wings and things, so yeah, it's all very Area 88 in places. So here we go, start game. Now this, I'm not sure if this is work in progress, this is the pack file that I found, but it's not complete, and you can see that's sort of not quite there. You can only pick one fighter at the moment, which is Shin Kazama from Area 88 in an F-22 Lightning. So again, more sprite rips from various different games. All very interesting. I do like these sprite based intros. Seems to be some kind of coup d'etat going on, and it's up to Shin Kazama to stop it. I know that you've been invaded. And the transmission was ended. Make that decision. Pilots, please, passing. Yep, this commander. Can't select those two guys yet. International assistance. Yep, Mickey and Shin from Area 88 are here. Great. And Mal and Malcolm from Sonic Wings. Oh my god. The news is terrible. It's always terrible. Attacking Tokyo. Let's get ready. And Saki's there from Area 88, and the target is some stuff. And good luck. That's very rude of him. And this is ripped directly from Air Gallet, this intro bit. So, it's a sideways scrolling shoot 'em up rather than a beat 'em up, and I've already taken some hits. Well done, me. And also, sound rip from Afterburner. Isn't that cool? That's amazing. That's what I really like about this OpenBOR stuff. They can just rip stuff from other games, not because they're being cheap or being pirate, but it's like a what if you mashed up this with this? Excellent. And this is one of the most unusual usages, I should say, of OpenBOR a shoot 'em up. And of course, you know, I'm all about the shoot 'em ups. Fantastic. Do we have a smart bomb? Oh, we have a roll. Excellent. Not a bread roll. Just an aerial roll. I mean, even that enemy 3 o'clock is ripped from Afterburner. Excellent. So we got a fade out and a fade back in, a slightly different stage with some different music. I don't recognise what this track's from. We appear to be flying over some clouds now. Gameplay hasn't changed a great deal, it's still the same waves of enemies. But then again, you've got to remember, this is a homemade thing. It's made using this open source engine, and evidently one person working on this, maybe two, and putting, you know, wanting to put a lot of effort in. But you know, at the end of the day, it's probably a passion project more than anything else. I do like the aircraft designs. Most of them are recognisable as actual aircraft. Oh, what's this? This is a bomber. It's a B-52. It was a B-52. Right, I've had to restart it because unfortunately it crashed. So I played through again and then it crashed again, so something's not quite stable there, but okay, it wasn't really coming up with anything new. But it's a shame really, because I'd like to see this like developed more with maybe some more sprite bits from other aircraft based shoot 'em ups. So yeah, I might try it another time and have a better look, see if there's an updated version of it. But interesting work nonetheless. Right, so here with some music that's going to get me a copyright strike no doubt, here's He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. Again, a fan game, but very authentic looking. I mean, obviously that's the standard BOR interface, but authentic sound effects too. Okay, we're going to go into game mode. Select player, He-Man, She-Ra, Battle Cat, Manic Arms, Teela, Ram Man, well, fucking Orko, the Sorceress, Evil-Lyn, Skeletor, Panthor, and Lino? Okay. Right, we're going to go Skeletor, because funds. And Hordak is the bad guy, so this explains why we're playing a Skeletor, because he's been banished by Hordak. And you have a map screen. Now, so let's just pick a stage. There's a lot of stages there, so I think what we'll do is what the hell's going on? We'll have a look at a couple of stages, you know, and cut between them. But so far, this guy with the axe, he's just running over like a nutcase. I mean, the graphics on this are excellent. They ripped this from the cartoon, haven't they? This guy, seriously. Yeah, that told you. That's another one. They're just, this guy with the axe, just running around like a nutcase. The Skeletor's almost been killed by a nutcase just running backwards and forth across the screen like a idiot. What's these? Oh, we've got some of Hordak's troops here, which are easier to hit than stupid axe bloke. Oh, you can dash. Good. There we go. And they all fall to bits easily like they do in the cartoon. Couple of hits and they explode. Oh, and that's one of those things. What? I don't know why Skeletor suddenly appeared there. But this is very slick for the game. There's great big fisting coming from above. What? Oh, I see. You can free people from this and bash the gun turrets up and avoid the big fisting. Right. Can we move along, or do we have to destroy the fisting? I mean, Who is doing the fisting? Is it your mum? Oh, some snakes and stuff. Oh, okay. Am I being attacked by a panther? That's not on brand. That's my cat. Oh, no, now we've got access to panther. Fantastic. Off we hop. And we've got to hit these turrets. Excellent. Very impressed with the way this looks. It plays a bit loose, shall we say. It's not as refined as Golden Axe, but it really does look very, very good. It almost looks professional. Apart from these stupid horned idiots running around with axes. Luckily, Panthor makes things a lot easier. Shall we have a look at one of the other stages, maybe with a different character? Yes, let's do that. Let's go. Right, picking He-Man this time. And there's already a platforming bit, I'm presuming. Again, with a great big disembodied hand. Again. I don't know what I'm going to do here. That's very, very strange. Also, the jumping plane seems a little bit... What? We jump over this shit? No. That's mad. And I've just completely failed that jump twice. Brilliant. So we go back and pick another level, because this... I know I've got to try and hit it, but... Shit. Oh! Okay, we've got a... I can't remember what Shira's flying unicorn's called, but we've got that. Shooting against Hordak's robots and flying things. And that lack of sound for some reason. Again, you can't really complain too much because this is probably made by just a few guys in their spare time. But I am so impressed with the amount of effort they've gone to making this look authentic. I mean, there's been He-Man games in the past and none of them have even looked this good. That's really, really good work. I mean, the backgrounds, they're probably lifted from the paintings of the actual backgrounds. Right, that was a very quick stage. Let's see what this one does. Yep, bash stuff up. And these are landmines, I presume. Landmines are evidently a problem as in Eternia as they are in any other war zone. Hordak cares not for the UN. Yeah, again, it's standard Beats of Rage stuff. It's a little bit repetitive. I'm just in awe of how authentic looking and sounding it is. It really captures the atmosphere and look of the Yetis cartoon series. Right, so we've picked Lino because he shouldn't be here. He's crossed the multiverse of madness and ended up in a He-Man game for some reason, but sure, I'm here for him. That's all good. And there's more rolling boulders and these very well animated tentacles and these jackal things. Is that... No, Jackal Man was in Thundercats, not He-Man. And these things I pick up, okay. Oh, shadow creatures. Again, I think they were a He-Man staple. Yep, three the idiots. Smash the robot in the face. Oh, another fisting. There we go, that's all them. And some spider robot things, they're creepy, aren't they? And I've just noticed this is four players. So I don't think there's enough going on screen to warrant there being four people, but maybe, hey, the enemy count goes up. Wow, like a Vengabus? The Vengabus is here, brilliant. From New York to San Francisco, we broke down in Eternia. Excellent. Oh, stupid horned guys. One of them's going to start running around with an axe in a minute. But yeah, I digress. The He-Man pack for the Open BOR, surprisingly authentic, and a lot of work's gone into it. Just needs a little more variety in places, but no, it's fine. So, seeing Lino in the He-Man game got me thinking, well, maybe there's a Thundercats game. And surely enough there is. This is Thundercats, the Super Lost Eye of Thundera. It's not what you think. It really isn't. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. This is a Beats of Rage conversion of the Commodore 64 Spectrum and Amstrad Thundercats game from, what, 1988? Dragged kicking and screaming out of its grave to a PC near you, and wow, this is was not on my 2024 bingo list. Wow, I remember this came out, this got really, really hyped for the 8-bit system specifically, but wow, what a thing to convert to Beats of Rage. I mean, full marks for completely throwing a wild card here, but I was really expecting sort of a, well, a side was going beat 'em up, but why not, eh? We've had a side was going shoot 'em up in Beats of Rage, why not a remake of a really moldy 8-bit game? To be honest, it doesn't play too badly. You only get one life, one hit per life, so you've got to be careful. I'm sure there's people out there who will remember this the first time round. I know I did. This is why I'm just so surprised. Oh, look, I got stuck there. When I ran into Ghost Boy, whatever his name is, I can't even remember his name. I was stuck. Oh, that was cheesy, you jumping idiot. I bet you the water kills you, because quite obviously Thundercats drown in water, but oh, I see, for some reason I can walk through some of these things, but not all of them. Oh, crap, see? I'm not going to be playing beyond the lives that Lino already has. He had 9 because cats, but yeah, it's. I'm just so surprised. I'm just so surprised. We've reached the end of the second stage. Oh, it's Jackal Man. Well, I don't remember there being bosses in the original version, but that's an interesting little thing. Oh! This was not in the original version. There was a stage where you were on some jet bike thing, but actually in the Thunder Tank, shooting what looks to be some sort of Christmas tree decoration. But that's interesting. They've mixed it up a bit. A little bit of variety here. This is good. Don't we reach the end of that stage? And we're back into the sideways scrolling bits. Very, very bizarre. Still can't get over that somebody remade this crusty old game. But with actually a lot of care and attention and adding extra stuff to it as well, like a little boss fight and the overhead section. Really, really interesting. Do you know what, dare I say it, I'm sort of enjoying it. Not without its problems, but I'm just astounded it even exists. You know, the worst ways to spend a few minutes. Right, so there we go, a quick look at some games constructed in OpenBOR. What did you think of them? It's a very interesting subject. Have you tried them? Are you going to try them? Or are you even going to make one yourself? If you are, comment below.
Yeah, subscribe or naff off!